Welcome to PokeClass episode 7. Today, I'm going to give an analysis of a deck that people have been trying to revive since the loss of a certain supporter. But now with the new set Triumphant backing it up, this deck could easily become tier 1 yet again. Let's talk about Gyarados. Gyarados has shown its power in this year's Senior World Championship, coming second to Jacob Lesage's Luxchomp. This deck can deal a lot of damage in 1 or 2 turns for no energy, leaving room for a load of techs and or consistency cards to help get Gyarados swinging as fast as possible. Let's have a quick look at the basic strategy of Gyarados before the rotation. So first we have the main attacker, Gyarados from Stormfront. His first attack, Tail Revenge, does 30 times the number of Magikarp in your discard pile. This is where the main strategy behind playing Gyarados lies, with Magikarp. The main idea is to get as many Magikarps into your discard pile as quickly as possible, with the maximum amount being 3. Having all 3 in your discard pile means that Gyarados can be hitting for 90 per turn, or 110 with Expert Belt attached. As you may have noticed, this attack requires no energy, which means that this card can get set up as soon as you evolve it, making great chances to start KOing your opponent's basics as soon as they lay them down. Now, to discard the cards you need, you're going to need some help, and that did come in the form of Felicity's drawing. This card allowed you to discard 2 cards, hopefully them being Magikarps, and then draw either 3 or 4 extra cards depending on how many you discarded. This gives you the fuel you need to get attacking with Gyarados. Now with the rotation, all Gyarados players lost the main card of the deck, Felicity's Drawing, which hurts the deck's speed quite a bit. So now we have a gap between the rotation of a key card and the release of some great new cards from Triumphant to find another way to discard cards to build up damage. The most common I've seen used are Volgner's Philosophy and Regice from Legends Awakened. Volgner's Philosophy allows you to discard a card from your hand and then draw until you have 6. This gives a good source of draw power if you have a small hand, but more importantly, can get those Magikarps into the discard pile. However, this can't live up to Felicity's because you're only getting rid of 1 carp rather than 2 per turn, slowing you down. There is also the alternative of using Regice. Regice's PokePower Regi move allows you to discard 2 cards from your hand to switch your opponent's Pokemon with another from their bench. Not only is this a great way to get out trainer locks such as Spiritomb, but it also lets you discard 2 cards from your hand, both of which could be Magikarp. Good things about this is that it discards the same amount of cards as Felicity, you can disrupt your opponent by shifting Pokemon, and you can use a supporter the same turn, as it is a power rather than a card. Bad things include Power Spray, if you're facing SP, and Regice's Retreat Cost if you start with it, being as you run little energy in this deck. Both of these cards worked great with the right build, but they seem to still slump below the quickness Felicity's Drawing could have, being that it let you draw more cards after you discarded. Let's move a little ahead of time and look at the new set, HeartGold SoulSilver Triumphant. This is where Gyarados players will be looking at 2 main cards to get the ball rolling on making this hard-hitting dragon a tier 1 deck for another season. The 2 cards I'm talking about are Junkarm and Rescue Energy. The trainer card Junkarm allows you to discard 2 cards from your hand to grab a trainer other than Junkarm from your discard pile. Now this is the card which could be the successor to Felicity's Drawing that all Gyarados players have been looking for. Not only does this let you do the same discard as Felicity, but it's a trainer rather than a supporter, meaning that you can play other things like Pokemon Collector to grab and discard those cards as soon as possible. You can also use Junkarm to grab discarded Expert Belts or other trainers that you might need following a knockout on your fully powered Gyarados. The second card being released is also a great recovery card and it's called Rescue Energy. When a Pokemon with Rescue Energy attached gets knocked out, you can place the Pokemon back into your hand rather than the discard pile, which makes for a great recovery, especially if you have Broken Time Space out, as next turn you can put Magikarp down, evolve to Gyarados, and then you're back for hitting 90 per turn straight away. Speedy recovery is what makes Gyarados such a pain to get rid of, and having Rescue Energy means that after knocking out one Gyarados, the same one will come back to return the KO next turn. You team this combination with cards that are already running Gyarados, such as Pokemon Rescue, Super Scoop Up, and Cynthia's Feelings, you have a Pokemon that's going to be hard to get rid of. Let alone being able to recover Gyarados a maximum of 4 times with Super Scoop Up, you can add that to a potential 4 Rescue Energy to make that 8 times you can place down the same Gyarados in one game, which is incredible as it means you're going to be rarely without an attacker. However, with the release of Triumphant comes Gengar Prime, which may pose some problem to Gyarados players. Gengar can place any Pokemon it knocks out into the Lost Zone, This could pose a problem for Gyarados, as it thrives off of recovering as quickly as it sets up, so having parts of Gyarados in the Lost Zone, mainly Magikarp, makes for a tougher time. However, depending on how ruling goes, Rescue Energy may be able to save you from the Lost Zone. With Rescue Energy allowing you to put Gyarados back into your hand after a KO, you may be able to avoid Gengar's placement into the Lost Zone. This will, however, need to be put down as a ruling into which one will happen first, either Rescue Energy or Gengar's Catastrophe, so we'll have to wait and see. Gengar's Plunge into Darkness will also be a problem, because if you go first with your Sableye and collect for 3 Pokemon, namely Magikarp, and they get a Gengar out, your 3 Pokemon will be gone into the Lost Zone for the rest of the game. This makes Gyarados impossible to get set up, as the Magikarps are gone for you to power up with. Gyarados has been a powerful deck, especially last format, and with Felicity's gone, people didn't think it was quick enough to keep up with the rest, but with the release of Triumphant just around the corner, Gyarados is set to make a comeback. If any of you don't know about the Gyarados list people are running at the moment, then here's a quick rundown of a pre-Triumphant list. So we start with 4 Magikarp and 3 Gyarados. We have more Magikarp because they're going to stay in the discard pile for the most part of the game. Next we have 4 Sableye, the starter of the deck. Putting this guy as your active first turn means you're going to be able to grab the Magikarp you need with Pokemon Collector by using Impersonate straight away. You can even use it a few turns in a row if needed to get Karps into the discard pile or even refresh your hand. Then there's Regice. You're going to want one of these, as putting more in means you have a higher chance of starting with it and no way of retreat. This card lets you discard 2 cards and move your opponent's Pokemon around. This is great the turn after you've impersonated for the Magikarp. On top of that, it's great for countering Spiritomb. This list is pretty Pokemon thin, as you need a lot of support for recovery and discarding cards, but you're definitely going to need 2 Uxie for draw power. Crobat G is also an option in Gyarados, to add extra damage you need when 90 just isn't enough for the KO. For trainers and supporters, you're going to need 4 Volcanoes Philosophy for maximum chance of drawing into one straight away, and max out on Pokemon Collector too, for the same reason. Other things you're going to want to max out on are Super Scoop Up and Pokemon Rescue, as you want maximum recovery of your Gyarados if it gets KO'd. Next, you'll want to include Bebe Search to grab what you need at the right time, Expert Belt for added damage when needed, and more importantly, Broken Time Space, which gives you the speed you need to get Gyarados active as fast as possible. As for energy, you don't really need any, unless one of the techs you have needs to attack. You may decide to put in 4 Special Dark, so that you have the option to donk with Sableye, which I would suggest doing. That's pretty much it for the basic pre-Triumphant list. There are a few techs that you can include, and the most interesting I've seen is Dialga G Level X, and running Warp Energy too. Dialga helps you deal with Pokemon like Vileplume, blocking your trainers, and running Warp Energy allows you to switch out after leveling up. Running Warp Energy also gives you the option to switch out Regice if you manage to start with it. That's my analysis of how Gyarados is going to make a comeback into Tier 1 for another season after the new set is released. What do you think about Gyarados' comeback after the new set? Make sure you subscribe and check back next week for another PokeClass. Thanks for watching.